was able to get myself into a 150. You're going to have a variation of things, but typically people do the same thing over. Once it fills up, he's probably going to say pot, or he's just going to run straight in. So I usually wait. If I don't see him say pot, I'll just start potting. So pot. Alright, he went inside, so look for that. You don't want to be the last guy in. Double check your view. Okay, so this first room, you're going to want to drop an inventory slot to pick up a thing to fill water with. And then you're going to just fill water. You do not want to be the guy who doesn't fill water right away. So now I'll show you what I mean. Alright, let's do this. Alright, so you want to pick up the water container right away. So usually I just drop it, pick it up, and then I like to go to this side. So there's like a pattern here. You don't want to run in these, obviously, and you want to go this way and then back this way. So, but you didn't fuck me up. If you do this right away, you can just like speed through it, get a lot of points. So just kind of click fast. If you take damage, it loses points here. It's all about like the timing of the clicks, but eventually you kind of figure it out. So for the first one, I stand here with the alligator. Oh, I usually hit the alligator, but I have nothing hidden, so let's fix that. Another one, go, and I gotta wait. And yep, just keep doing that till it fills up. And then you go to the boss room. Like I said, I like this side the best. I think they're all a little different. Yeah, should be able to finish it out. It'll disappear if you don't destroy it, so don't worry about doing that. Alright, so this room is going to be range. You can use the staff if you have it, but it wastes money in my opinion, and it's about the same point, so. Yeah, and if you have the ZCB, this is what you're going to want to use here for sure. Or the TiVo. Alright, in this room, I pray flick. It saves prayer pots. It literally lets me bring one less one, but you don't have to. I wouldn't do it at first, honestly. So you want to use your spec weapon. That's it. So the balls are mage and the other ones are range. Usually people will do that for you. Don't worry about it. If you buy it, you'll do it. It's mage. So literally, if you're gonna pray flick, you literally just do it when it's right next to your bed. So just boop, boop. So it saves a whole entire slot. You can bring an extra brew, which I usually end up dropping anyways. So that's it. It's gonna go in waves though. So these things you wanna run away from. If you move, they'll go away from you. These waves, you want to go in here. Prayer freaking is so easy though. Like, if you get hit by these waves, you're gonna fucking die. Not really, but you're gonna fucking die. It'll push you in here, and then you gotta climb up that. No, what did I do? Alright, that's the first room. Easy. Next, everyone usually does this room. This is a puzzle. People will usually do the puzzle for you, but as you learn it, you get more points. And then there's a plugin for it. It's called like TOA puzzle or something like that. But you'll just learn this as you go, really. People usually will just do it for you, to be honest. I'm gonna do it because I want the keys. helps a lot. And this one, I do not like doing. So I'm gonna let these fools do it. Rat. Yo, pick one. Yeah, so I never do that one. Right, here, if you have claws, throw your spec right away. I don't know how the ZCD works here, but 60 attack, you're pretty much fucked because this is a crush item. You have the staff, you're good. If you don't, you're gonna want to desort it, and yeah, it fucking sucks. You get like no damage here. All right, so the dung is gonna happen right away. If it's double dung, the first two people here are gonna be the ones to throw the dung. Just make sure you're not one of the first two in the lobby, but eventually it's gonna keep doing it. This thing prey range, and then I do like a couple hits, and then I go for the swaps. These things heal this guy. So you always want to be moving in this room as well. These things are gonna come like periodically. It's like every few ticks. It's like a pattern. So I just go like one, two, three, click away. Two, three. It's like a little pattern you get used to, honestly. This is why you need your blowpipe. So the dung's gonna take a while to get used to, but this is why I bring freezes though. Freeze this thing for everybody. If you don't do that and it attacks you have to protect melee or you're gonna get fucking wiped. This thing you wanna attack right away because it'll hit for 70s, which it's about to do because no one's attacking it. Ooh. We're good. It's back to doing this. Remember, always move around, look out for the shadows. Go back to this. Peacock. Watch, just like boom. One, two, three, move. Da da da. Right. See, this is when someone fucks the dung up, you get trapped. It's not too bad, but if you're doing melee and it blocks out, you can't hit him. Like this guy, he's fucked. He had range, he could do something, but that's it. 150s are easy too, especially if they don't have walk the path on. This shit's fucking right, these. If you're gonna do it first, get life. This is most heals. You want this if you have a DDS usually, but I would do this at first, but I'm gonna do that because I've done this 300 times, so. This room as well, people will just kind of do it for you. I try to help out, get as many points as possible, so I just do it anyways. Need a pickaxe. It's like a mirror thing. You have to hit this thing eventually. Just kind of, eventually you know what to do. Simple. So think, think, think. Wanna hit that thing. That's it. And three. Drink a beer. Avoid these because they're gonna hit you for damage. But not worth it. Here, take it. Excuse me. I pick my salt right here because why not? A lot of this you're gonna figure out your own methods, so mine is not the exact. So in for one fucking game. Okay, here it's gonna aggro someone. Usually you'll have someone who butterflies. If not, just stay away from this motherfucker. People are gonna want you to DD on them. Tell them to fuck off, because that's how you get PK'd by somebody. Gonna do my own thing. This motherfucker's gonna PK me. This is like a memory thing, just kinda walk. Alright, so range magic is melee. Check the range. Always keep your HP high. It's not worth dying. Even if you brew down, your salt keeps you up. These ones, if you have mage, use mage. If not, I'll use your blowpipe. I think it's next best DPS. This is going to be magic. So it goes in a cycle. It goes melee, range, mage. Unless... feeling, or not feeling special, unless the one of the invocations on, then it's random. This is range. Back to mage. Alright, so white is going to blow up this way and this way on your character. You either want to DD, but you don't want to be lined up with somebody, because you're going to get clapped. That's why I just try to stay away from everybody, because if you're running with a bunch of noobs, they're going to get you killed, essentially. And also, this thing goes in a clockwise, like this. It's gonna spawn a shadow. You have to kill the shadow before you can hurt this dude. This guy. He just PK'd. Nice one, bud. See, that's why. Hit him with the thanks. Fucking bum. Usually if I wasn't commentating, I would not let someone stand under me because they fucking kill you. In higher invocations, if that black thing hits you, it drops your prayer and you would just take instant 60 and fucking die. And you can attack from all these squares with your blowpipe. This, you want blowpipe over this, unless you have crystal armor or a T-bone. Okay, when he drops, it's the orb phase. Fucking heal up. Get your prayer high. And then it's going to be melee. Alright, if you have a claw spec, do not spec right away. It'll make this thing disappear. All specs will just make it disappear right away. But I always wait a tick so everyone hits, and then I'll do it. But it didn't work, so let him hit, and then do it. See, it disappears right away. Keep your HP high here, too. I always safe up, not worth dying. Seems at like 20s. That's it. Great, now it's the most difficult room. Like I said, I would recommend... when you go get your potions from that lady from the first one, do not go this one. You want to go help, because if you're playing with shitty players, this is the make or break room that will take all your fucking food. Ugh. Little drunk voice. so this means I'm calling. It's either going to be vents, pillar, or DD. DD is you have to pour this potion to cure everybody. You don't. If everyone doesn't do all four, you'll take damage. Straight away, protect melee. And then next range, that's V. If you're the caller, you hit V. You pour this potion here. If you're not the caller, just still try to pour the potion on me. Alright, rangers are weak to melee. These shamans you want to kill right away with range. These spawn all the melees. These melees are weak to everything. The big red melees are only weak to mage, pretty much, I'm pretty sure, and range melee again. And then there's these mage guys I kill with melee. I mean, range. Sorry. You have to call right away, too. So these I bring freezes so I can freeze them. Because if you step on that, you get venomed. That's why I bring a sand few. Because, yeah, it should fuck you up. As a peer, you want to try to help out as much as possible and do the best because people fucking cry. So I always try to go for the shamans and I always try to freeze the dudes who drop venom. It's just a good team player. Let's go in. These are weak to mage. And this is a good room for blood barrages because you take a lot of damage and you just heal up. People never do that, and it helps out so fucking much. No, stay away from those. They'll hit you big. Just like that. Higher invos, it hits you for like fucking 50s. Once you hear the noise, you'll hear the noise when you get cured and you can run away. I fucking run away right away because sometimes those bombers will leave there when people are lagging and you'll get stacked out and you just fucking die. But a lot of this you kind of learn as you go, so. That's it. We got a low invo, so this is really easy. Sometimes this is a lot harder than it looks. Nevertheless, it's not too bad. So caught up. Here I like to salt up, and I like to use my adrenaline just so I can get a lot of dragon claw specs. It works too if you have the ZCB. I probably still use it here. It's really up to you. Some people save this to the end. It's all preference. Of course, the aggro's new. Never really happens. Just four spec. I'm going to put this away so I don't accidentally drink it. Alright, these you want to be four to rock. It's split equally. If you don't, if there's more than four to rock, you're going to take like a 50. So, this room as well, always stay high. Do not let your HP drop low. Not worth it. Okay, here, shoot range at the rocks. Usually people will be able to skip it for you. Like, watch, he'll skip this. And then you hit this with melee, and then it stops the boulders. Alright, these monkeys, as a peer, will fuck you up. So, sometimes I'll just stay protect range if I'm not getting attacked. Or I'll actually, like, actively try to kill these motherfuckers. Alright. So if I would have went there, someone would have took 50. Instead, I went to one of the mummies, which you take half the damage, I'm pretty sure. So I just did that so that no one died, and I knew I had food, and that'd be safe to go there. So you can keep using those until they blow up like that, which these monkeys will break them, as you can see right there. So fuck these monkeys, they suck. Don't do that. Try to get ahead of myself. See, watch. someone's gonna take 50. Oh no, he knew what to do. See, sometimes you have rats who don't care and they'll just fucking go. But I mean, it is what it is. You gotta take a chance sometimes. See, in lower invocations, it's not worth taking your thing here because you waste 30 seconds of extra specs. It's all about choices. Yeah, this one I go life. I still have my thing for the last phase. This fills you up all the way. These are just prayer things. This will just keep giving me prayer. Someone has to tank these sides. Usually someone will just tank it for you. Otherwise, everyone just DDs here. Tanking it allows one of these sides to use a special first. If you don't, they're going to use them at the same time, and you're probably going to die. I don't know why he dropped that, but I might just steal it. We'll see. Okay, you're going to use mage on this, or range. That was mean. Oh yeah, you have to ready up on that guy, by the way. Don't be that guy. Okay, these you don't want to be there, you're gonna die. The next one, mark this tile for white. The yellow, I mean. Going to that, you're gonna fucking die. This one is spread, and then there's gonna be another one that would become here. That would be DD. If you don't DD, you're gonna fucking die. But just kind of watch what everybody else does. All right, first phase is mage. It's gonna be mage and range, mage, and that's range. Okay, look at. You can wait a while to put up the prayer, so you don't have to really rush it, but alright, this one, you can either stand there for being safe, or you can run through it, but you're probably going to die here at first, and you'll kind of figure it out as you go. Alright, usually I have my journal on out, but commentating, so I forgot. Next one is range. Here as well, keep your HP high. It's gonna drop your prayer. It's gonna either be mage, range, or melee. Alright, this one, mark this tile, step one tile. That's it. I like to stand in these four tiles the entire time, pretty much. Okay, this is DBS phase. This is why journaling is good, it doesn't use all your spec, you get a lot of points here. This is also why I did the Colossal Blade, because when you have a DBS, you barely use this, and it's better than a D-Sword. It hits way higher, as you'll see right here. It's like a 46 or some shit. And we're back to range. Mage on here. This is going to stop you if you don't move, you get mudded up. There's also one that'll shoot these orbs, and you either have to, oh, here we go, you either have to line up two squares from it, or be far away enough to not get hit. So you can either be there for safe, as that guy just did, or be far away from it. Higher invos, it'll drop your prayer, and you'll just get fucking one hit, so be careful. That's why I like staying here, it doesn't really come over here. Is so easy, these 150s. Alright, so again, I'll salt up and then I'll bring up my pot. Like this. Put that for somebody. Like that. So, if someone drops adrenaline, I just fucking jack that shit. It gives you more specs. If you have the ZCB here, it is best in slot. Because it hits hundreds. But unfortunately, I don't have the cap. trash stack. I spent it all on this fucking stack. Also, if you don't have staff, you want to use this, the bofa. If you don't have the bofa, I don't know what to tell you. Probably use any sort of crossbow with ruby bolts spec. I want the ruby bolts. Okay, so now it's going to start dropping that. We need to watch your prayer. It's going to be... Obviously, that's mage. The other one's range. It's mage. Spec on here. Don't know what's going here. So these rocks will fall like where you stand, like the tick or two before. So you just gotta kind of be careful. It'll fuck you up. Once you get the hang of it, it's just like a big pattern, really. It's fucking easy after that. Very fun. Very, very fun. Honestly, D-claws suck here, but I don't have a spec weapon, so... Alright, this part. You want to, like, watch for these shadows, and you need to be watching at the same time. So my thing is, I go this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, hit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, hit. 1, 2, 3, 4. You just kind of bounce around. And you just go to the square that's empty. Once you get a feel for the ticks, it's pretty fucking easy. Just never stop moving. It's almost like PKing. That's it. Good luck. And that is how you do TOA. Second place, not bad. GG's pack.